Coming to you from our GIS studios, I am Anicia Antoine, and this is your Midday News Brief. St. Lucia now has a resident representative to the Organization of American States, OAS. Lili Ching Soto presented her letters of credence to the Minister responsible for External Affairs, Honorable Sarah Flood Bobre, on Friday, September 6, 2019. The Costa Rica native has been working with the OAS since 1999. She has worked extensively on human rights issues with the Inter-American Commission on Human Rights at the OAS. Her most recent position was the Principal Human Rights Specialist on that commission. Outstanding youth of Gros Islet had their moments in the spotlight as they were recognized for their achievements in the Common Entrance Examination, the Caribbean Secondary Education Certificate, and Junior Carnival 2019. The Gros Islet Constituency Top Achievers Awards is an annual event sponsored by the Taiwanese government. Ambassador of the Republic of China Taiwan to St. Lucia, His Excellency Douglas Shen, encouraged the students to continue giving of their best. He expressed hope that one day the top achievers will be recipients of the Taiwanese scholarships as well. Minister for Equity, Social Justice, Local Government and Empowerment and Parliamentary Representative for Gros Islet, Honorable Leonard Montout, motivated the recipients to keep working towards their goals despite the odds they may face. The 8th Annual Gros Islet Constituency Top Achievers Awards Ceremony was held on Friday, the 6th of September 2019. A delegation of European Union representatives has given a nod of approval to a number of climate resilient initiatives being undertaken in St. Lucia by the Disaster Vulnerability Reduction Project, DVRP. The EU delegation toured the Schwarzel Secondary School and the abandoned PI Community Centre, as well as the construction site of the PI Bridge and rehabilitation of the ancillary Venus Link Road. The EU representatives lauded the projects given their significance in lessening the potential negative impacts of weather-related events by ensuring that communities remain accessible and social and economic activities are minimally disrupted. This has been your Midday News Brief. Thank you for watching.